Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Dynasty in NCAA 13. Got some more recruiting for you today before we jump into the ball game. Taking a look at our chart here. This is probably the smallest recruiting board I've had numbers wise since playing this game. Only 15 people on the recruiting board as of right now. That's because I've deleted some people who were kind of dead weight. We don't have quite as many needs now that a few people have signed early. Looking at Eddie Galloway as one of our prospects there from Maryland. Again, we want to open that pipeline to Maryland. So Eddie Galloway is of top importance for us. Plus, he's in the 70s rating coming in overall, which would be good. Lee Harris, free safety. That's another position of need right now. So taking a look at a couple people at that position as well. So going from there, we've got Ernest Spicer, who's another free safety. Also looking at him, he's got us at the top of his board, so we'll continue to pursue him. What else are we looking at in the recruiting field? We'll see here when we're done with Ernest Spicer. We move on to Gerald Payne. He's the number two athlete on the board, and we really have no shot at him, but he's from Brooklyn Park, Minnesota, so I want to take a shot at him. Just because we'll probably end up dropping off this board pretty soon if we don't make major progress, and we're certainly not doing that. So Joe Stokes has us number one, though, and he's a good tight end prospect. He's down a little bit here. He's to a 69 overall after dropping three spots, and we have scouted him at 100% now. But that's still something that'll help our roster, I believe, so we'll continue to pursue him. Looking at Jonathan Ellis, the center. Center is another position of need. So we'll definitely scout him out to the best of our ability here. We got him at, is it 90% or 100%? Yep, and he's officially a bust for most teams. But for us, he would be a nice find, but we are third on his list. So Joel Meadows is an athlete here. Going to look at him too, the four-star athlete. And he's from Massachusetts, so he's definitely in the pipeline. That's all good. We need to scout him up a little more. These athletes take forever to scout, so being at 45%, put all this time in, and we'll still only be at 75%. So he's a 71 overall. Next up is Corey Harvey, also from Maryland, and we are number one on the board. That is one of our ways into that pipeline to Maryland. So we'll continue to scout him. We got a long way to go, only 18% scouted. When we're done with this, we're only 36% scouted. Okay, well, so we really don't know where he's going to finish out overall, but we're still going to pursue him. Because even if he is a bust, he's from Maryland after all, and we could use that. So Marquise Gilliam, also from Maryland, but we're second on his board, and it's a distant second. I think we're just going to go ahead and discard him right now. Not going to waste our time. So everyone's favorite recruit, Max Bush. Who doesn't want to be getting Max Bush? You know how it goes. I make that joke every single time, and I don't know why I went back to it again, but there you go. So we're pursuing Max Bush. I think he may be a distant brother from another mother of Harry Bush, Junk Gaming Videos character. Although, Harry Bush is white and this guy isn't, so I don't know. We'll have to explore that more. But it's game day, guys! It's time to take on Northern Illinois. And they're 0-4, inexplicably. I don't know. That's a team that's, in real life, played in a BCS bowl game this year. But here they're 0-4. That's really strange. But I guess that's the life of a MAC team in non-conference play. Well, anyway, we know how it is to play a team that has not won a game and to lose to them. That's what happened in the Boston College game. Trying to avoid that here, handing off to Jim Mitchell to the left-hand side. And he uses that speed to get a first down. That's a great start to this game. You see the replay here, showing off that 94 overall speed. Just hopefully he does not get injured, because he does seem to be very injury-prone as well as fast. So on first and 10, hand off to Mitchell. Following his fullback forward, doesn't get much there. It'll be second and 9. Wesley Collins, look out! Guard decided not to block on that play. Was it the guard or tackle? No, it was the guard. He was a turnstile on that play, never even got a hand on him, and just about got his freshman quarterback put 6 feet under. That's not a good strategy at all. Junk Johnson's going to get a hold of him on the sideline and ask him what was up on that, but right now it's third and 15, going deep to the sideline. They got two players there to knock that down. Not a very sound choice by Wesley Collins, but it's probably because he's still got cobwebs in his head from taking that hit earlier in the series. So the ball goes over after a punt, and you look at Northern Illinois, not really looking like an 0-4 team. They look like they've got some momentum and some polish going here on offense in this first drive, as you see a couple connections here through the air. that this looks like a pretty decent team. So we got to be kind of careful on this day. Second and 9 now. McIntosh has no rush in his face, and he's going to throw to the sideline for a first down. That's going to be first and goal. No problem there, pitch and catch. They've got first and goal. So McIntosh on that first and goal play is going to have some time again to throw. Waits for his wide receiver to break off his man, and it's a touchdown. So just like that, Northern Illinois gets the ball and scores. Defense really doesn't provide much of anything to stop them on this drive. So we're going to have to work on that when they get back on the sideline. Junk Johnson's got a lot of coaching to do. Got to coach him up. So on first and 10, Wes Collins going to hand off to Jim Mitchell, who gets about 4 yards. Nothing special on that play. Second and 6 now. Collins going to throw behind Howard, but he does make the catch. He adjusts well. Third and inches. What are we going to do on this play? Well, we're going to hand off to the fullback, Coleman, and he gets drilled. He does not get the first down. It's fourth and inches. Northern Illinois' defense ready to gut off the field. Only problem is Junk Johnson's taking a risk here at his own 30. He's going to go for it. Fourth and 1. What does he call? Fullback again. Coleman just barely gets it. Wow, that was really close. First and 10 curl route to Ronnie Parker. Going to make the catch. Another first down. He's dangerous. They got to give him some space because he'll burn him. Jim Mitchell up the middle for 9 yards. It'll be second and inches. Once again here, we got third and 11 after a sack. But here we go to Quayshon Smith, who makes the catch. It is first and 10. They jump off sides on this play. Jim Mitchell's got a free play. Going to try to hurdle and get smashed. Look at what the call is here. Obviously, it's offside on the defense. We're going to go ahead and take that and get first and 5 opportunity on this play. So on first and 5, hand off to Jim Mitchell again. Not much there. 2 yards. Second and 3. Keep going to that running game. Why don't we? Northern Illinois knows it's coming, and they make a stop. It's now third and 4. Big play here. What can we do? Well, now our own O-line jumps offside. What's the matter with them? Don't they know I'm trying to do the hard count? Apparently not. So we got third and 9 now instead of third and 4. That's no good. We set up the screen and probably should have gone to the screen because it was kind of set up. Instead, he throws into double coverage and it's picked off. Not even close to who he was throwing to, which was Fozell, the tight end. I guess you got to look at it as this. It was about as successful as a punt could have been, getting him down to about the 7-yard line. But still, Jim Mitchell's like, give me the ball, man. I was set up on the screen. So that's a mistake. And here we go again with Northern Illinois' offense getting a first down. We got to try to disrupt this rhythm somehow. I don't know. McIntosh has all day to throw again. He can pack a picnic lunch back there and have no problem eating that while they try to rush him. Throws a first down. This is starting to get concerning here for UMass's defensive coordinator, who I don't even know who the hell that is. I just made that up. But here's a first down. I don't think Junk has a defensive coordinator. I think he runs the show himself. Oh my goodness, we had that set up to stop that play, and we just didn't execute. That's not good football right there. They run the option. Quarterback should have gotten drilled. Instead, he gets downfield for good yardage. Boy, we got a lot to talk about at halftime. Hopefully, we can survive and still be in this ball game. There's another easy pass there. He does get a foot down in bounds, and it's first and goal. McIntosh going to hand off to Eakes. Eek, who the hell is Eakes? I don't think that's a running back, but yet he's bowling everybody over. Number 83, I'm presuming a tight end. McIntosh is going to call his own number, which is number 16, by the way, and he's going to rush for a touchdown right there. So UMass is looking pretty flat at this point, and they need to do something quickly to stay in this ballgame. Wes Collins is going to hit Ronnie Houston, the freshman, the 6'7 freshman, makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Second and 10 now, just over 2 minutes before halftime. Collins going to throw over the middle to Ronnie Houston again. He's going to get about 8 yards, third and 2. Hurry this up. Going to hand off to Jim Mitchell, and he's going to fight forward. He doesn't get it. We've got another fourth and inches, this one near midfield. He says, forget it, we're going for it. Went for it at our own 30. We're going to go for it at midfield. First down, Jim Mitchell. So here we go. Wes Collins gets him to jump off sides again, and Ronnie Houston drops this ball, or it could have been a big play. But as it is, they'll get 5 yards and another shot at third down. Too bad they couldn't connect right there. But reset it and see what they can do on third and 5. So getting another play. Wes Collins throws it right in the turf. Yeah, he's throwing off his back foot. Not very good mechanics there. And just add it to the first half woes. So they punt, and McIntosh has the ball. What's he going to do? He's going to get sacked. Maybe. Hilliard missed him. Oh, there you go. Smith gets in there and gets him. So timeout, and UMass gets the ball back with 41 seconds. Collins gonna throw to Markin Michel, makes the catch. And it's first and 10. Take a timeout there. UMass has two left. 35 seconds, and Collins gonna throw again. He's going deep. One-on-one coverage. Oh my goodness, look at Ronnie Houston get up and make that catch. What a catch. Using every inch of that 6'7" frame to make a catch. That's where he's a big advantage. This play is overthrown, but we get a break here on a true rarity. I hardly ever see this, but defensive pass interference is called. You can have the sliders way up, and I hardly ever see this in this game, but I'm going to take it because it gives us first and goal with 27 seconds left. Collins has every intention to hand off to Jim Mitchell, who's going to walk into the end zone and get UMass on the board for the first time today. So we see a replay here. Not much to see, just a handoff with no resistance. He goes into the end zone, and we've got a 14-7 ball game. UMass fans celebrating, the ones who actually showed up. You see our crowd, the seats are still, well, I don't know, would you say half full? Maybe a little more than half full. So Hail Mary time at the end of the second quarter, and it's going to be picked off by Jet. So there we go. We avoided letting any more points on that board before halftime. So we go into the third quarter on defense. So hopefully Junk scared the living hell out of this defensive unit here at halftime. Maybe threatened their mothers. I don't know what he did, but hopefully they come out with a little more fire. And hey, there's a nice third down play to knock that away. It looked like it was going to be a completion, but linebacker gets his mitt in there and knocks it down. So we're going to go with a second and 11 screenplay here. Mitchell is going to get pretty good yardage. He'll be third and three when all is said is done. So Collins to throw to Markin Michel, who's got a first down. There's a big third down conversion. Wesley Collins has thrown for 136 yards so far. Nothing to write home about, but hey, it's a start. So we got a draw play to Jim Mitchell. Here's a play to write home about. He's going down the right-hand sideline and almost gets into that end zone. Oh, God, he's hurt again. What did I say earlier in the ball game? Got to keep him healthy, but nope. He makes a big run only to get hurt. Let's see. This draw play works really well. And he got all the way down to the 5-yard line before contact. And somewhere in there, I don't know, didn't look like a brutal hit or anything, but somewhere in there he gets injured, so he's off the field. And you've got the fullback Coleman, who goes in for the touchdown. So no problem there. All of a sudden, we get a tie ball game. UMass responding and getting this all tied up. So let's see where we go from here. 14 all, 4 plays, 56 yards on that drive. And we got some news on Jim Mitchell. It's a high re-injury risk, so we're not going to sub him back in, at least at this point of the ballgame. Defense starts playing a little better here. Maybe they made some adjustments at halftime. I don't know. Third and 11. McIntosh to throw. And, oh, he gets chased down. That's a fumble. His own lineman falls on the ball, so luckily they don't turn the ball over right at their 15-yard line there, or 10-yard line, wherever their 15-yard line. But they are going to have to punt, so they're not seeing the success that they had in the first half, at least to this point. So nice play there by the UMass defense. You see Junk is fired up. Look at this. He said, yeah, that's the way I want you to play out there. And so they did. So third and 11 now. Wes Collins is going to throw one-on-one. Nope, that's knocked down. Trying to get to Ronnie Houston. That's a three and out. Back to Northern Illinois' offense. And McIntosh, he's going to roll awkwardly to the left and get sacked. Have some of that as a linebacker's right in his face. Third and long now, third and 15. Got to make a play here, get him off the field. McIntosh has some time to throw. He's going to step into this throw, and oh my goodness, I guess if you give him that much time, he'll find somebody open. That's a long first down play. Not good for UMass. McIntosh to throw again, another first down to Majors. So that gives them another first down. All of a sudden, they're getting in rhythm once again. Look out. Oh, speaking of look out, McIntosh gets hit hard, gets this pass out, and completes it. I don't know what that guy's hurtling for, but he gets taken down after getting yet another Northern Illinois Husky first down. There's another sack. They get in there. It's Randy Smith again. I think that's his second of the game. They've got four as a team. Second and 18. What'll the defense do? Oh, Randy Smith falls down, and McIntosh runs right past him. My goodness, he scrambles on second and 18 for another first down. Third and 10 now at about the 14. That's a draw play that's not going anywhere, so at least we've held them to a field goal attempt. So lining up for that field goal, and it's good. gives Northern Illinois the lead back at 17-14. And we're well into the third quarter now, so throwing to Ronnie Parker, trying to get this drive going. Let's go get those go-ahead points. Second and four, Wes Collins is going to hand off to Jim Mitchell, who gets a first down following his block by Fosell there and gets even a little more yardage. Closing in on the 100-yard mark, he's got 91. First and 10, let's hand off to him again. He's got some good blocking. Oh, my goodness, he gets undercut there after getting 7 yards. Second and three. Looking to give him to him again. And, oh, they rip it right out of his hands. It falls to the turf. And luckily, the fullback, Coleman, is there to fall on it. Wow, give him a big assist there, as that was almost a costly turnover. Wes Collins gets a blitz right in his face, but he does get the ball off to Fosell for the first down. Big play there. Hand off to Mitchell now to the left. He's going to have 4 yards. It'll be second and six. On the second and six play, Collins to throw. He's got some time, and he finds Fosell downfield. He's running. Oh, no, he dropped the ball. He fumbled the ball. We were inside the red zone with a chance to take the lead, and he fumbles the ball with a minute 25 left. That's heartbreak, folks. Let's watch the replay. He's been a solid tight end, but maybe this puts the distance between him and Blanchflower at this point, as he puts the ball on the ground in a crucial spot there. We do have 3 timeouts left, but we are running out of time. We need to make the stop right here. McIntosh is going to run forward. Oh, boy. Get him down on the ground. He gets 8 yards already. Second and two. We take a timeout. We need stops here. What do we get? Stop on second down. It'll be third and two. Got to do it again or this is pointless. Third and two. Powell going to try to come up and fill that gap. He gets blocked, but they do make the stop. Fourth and two. Timeout. We'll get the ball back one more time. So here comes the punt, and this possession truly will be do or die because we have no timeouts left. Got to field this first of all. Quayshon Smith, just don't fumble, please. Okay. So we're going to start at our own 39-yard line. Collins out of the shotgun here. A minute 5 to play. What can we come up with? He takes the snap. Quick throw to Mark and Michelle. Makes the catch. And they'll hurry up to the line. 55 seconds now. Collins, remember the clock stops with first downs. That one's out of bounds, so they'll have time to huddle up here now. Another first down catch. And with 50 seconds, Collins makes the snap. Oh, he's got Ronnie Parker open, and he makes the catch inside the 10. It's first and goal. That escalated quickly. So Ronnie Parker is trash-talking as he gets down there. How about he gets wide open again? Ronnie Parker in the end zone. Touchdown, and UMass, for the first time today, goes ahead. Oh, well, they used all the time on the clock to get there, pretty much. But they finally take a lead. So there's the replay. Ronnie Parker does catch it in the end zone. Luckily, he didn't trip over the chalk or something like, I don't know, there's been crazy things going on, but they get the lead. So 21-17. Let's see what the defense can do. McIntosh over the middle. Oh, boy, he hits his target. They've got a first down. This game's not over yet. Northern Illinois with 1 timeout left. And McIntosh escapes to the right. He's going to run. He's got a first down. Oh, no, this is our first half defense coming back at us here. 13 seconds left. I can't even look anymore. Okay, misfires there. Third and 10. Let me know when it's over. I don't even want to know. Oh, good, he threw an incomplete pass there. They're going to go for it on fourth and 10. Obviously, they have to. A field goal does nothing. McIntosh throws. Oh, he couldn't catch it. That would have been a big first down right there. Although I think they would have been out of time either way. So 21-17, take a knee, Wesley Collins, and UMass has their fourth victory of the year. They're 4-1 now. That one was way too close for a team that was 0-4 coming in. But like I said, you can't take anybody lightly when you're UMass. So 21-17, squeaker. They get it done at the end. The fans are probably a little bit exhausted after that, but happy they got the win nonetheless. Junk Johnson's like, yeah, okay, need to go take my heart medicine. But Jim Mitchell does get 102 yards on the day and does just enough to get this team a victory, I guess. Looking at the stats, Wesley Collins, 235 yards, a touchdown, an interception. Nothing special, but it's okay. Jim Mitchell goes over the 100-yard mark rushing. Coleman had 3 attempts for 1 yard, not too much going on there. And in the passing game, or the receiving game anyway, Ronnie Parker 4 for 52. You see Ronnie Houston 3 for 69. Decent performances all around, and the bottom line is we get the W today. So come on back next time for more UMass football. We're 4-1. right into the thick of MAC conference play, and we'll keep this series going. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.